All right, this is Advent of Code, day 21 in OCaml in 3, 2, 1, go. Monkey math, monkeys are back. You're worried they're gonna steal your stuff again. Seems like they're just holding their ground and making various monkey noises at you. What day is this? Day 11. Each monkey is given a job, either yell a specific number or yell, answer the riddle. Yell a specific number or yell the result of a math operation. All of the number yelling monkeys know their number from the start. Math operation monkeys need to wait for two other monkeys to yell a number, and those two other monkeys might also be waiting on other monkeys. Your job is to work out the number the monkey named Root will yell before the monkeys figure it out themselves. Each line contains the name of a monkey, a colon, and then the job of that monkey. Yell, okay, what will the monkey named Root yell? Monkey. Is either a number plus minus times minus. Num of int plus of int. Minus times divide. What name rest equals string dot split two? Split two option dot value x and s on in let name equals string dot prefix name for in. Try num int dot of string rest with times divide mm. Let monkey equals. In name monkey. Tag try. That monkeys. Monkey. Name two vowels. Two monkeys equals. Equals hash table of a list names and monkeys module string in let monkey values equals hash table dot create module string in while hash table dot length monkey values is less than hash table dot length. Hash table dot length monkey name two monkeys do hash table dot value x in monkey values root. This dot iter names and monkey if not hash table dot mem monkey values monkey dot name then match monkey dot eval monkey values with none some val hash table dot add x in monkey values key monkey dot name that data. And then let eval monkey t values equals match t with num n. M1, M2, Let apply TM1. V, apply T M1 V M2 V. Hash table dot of a list. What's wrong here? Hmm. Holy cow. Oh, okay. Part two. Whoa, Moali, thank you for the raid. Due to some kind of monkey mistranslation, you get the wrong job. You have the wrong job for the monkey named Root. Oh my God. What number do you yell to pass Root's equality test? Human of I'm not writing Rust right now. Human of human. And then human none. But symbolic eek. Interesting. Symbolic eval t values equals. None, some M2V. How do I want to do this? Part two. Monkey values. Hash table dot add set name to monkeys key human. What is it? Oh, human monkey dot human. Class size equals ref 0 in. Wow. Then human aha, okay. Let solve T. Do equals last size ref hash table dot length monkey values. Monkey dot solve human monkey. Name to monkeys monkey values. Monkey tmat and values equals. Let solve T dot test value. Equals solve hash table dot lookup find x and dmap map. Let to eek root zero. Fetch t with human test value eek How do I want to do this? Do 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 do. Okay.
but op t but operands plus minus times divide. Let M1 and M2 equal operands T. In let M1 be hash table dot find values M1 V. In let op equals opt in match M1B, M2B up with none. Solve both sides. Fail with already have both sides. Some A, some eek. None, some B, plus minus times divide, then I want to solve name. Let t equals hash table dot find x and t map t name in. Solve M2A, solve M1B, solve M2T. best value minus A. Solve and two. So we want A minus X, A minus test value. We want A X minus B to be B plus test value. Solve and two. Test value A, solve M2, A divided by X equals dest, A divided by dest value, B times dest value. Part two. Okay. Can't solve both sides. Human is used for BDQB. Oh my goodness, how long is this chain? Do 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 do. So then we solve human name. Solved equals. Printf. Should be T name solved. Printf. Ch equals
print equals. Print s name to monkeys string Mm-hmm.
Why aren't these evaluated? 5. 3. 32. Name two monkeys. Okay, human shows up here. So PTDQ is the only thing that depends on human. So LGBD is the only thing that depends on human. That's on me.
Okay.
PATQ. Wait, but also... hash table dot iter I. All right, gonna get it in under an hour. Nope, never mind. Dang it. Something has to appear twice. This is impossible. divide. Let's see. Need to solve T. Jeff can't solve TM. It will find X and T map. Can't solve because human. Printf should be able to solve.
option dot is none, then solve M1. Man, what is wrong with this? Okay. FJCF, yeah, shits, shits, fizzinswe, finzwe, bizwe, pujs, quim, humps, vivs. Shits can't find. Indent. Because indent. But indent equals indent. 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 Let's see. Need to solve. Oops. Oh my God. Now I'm very confused. Alright, can't call solve FJCF because of shits, can't solve shits because of finwiz, can't solve finwiz because of bizwa, pijwiz whip, fins, vpvs, but I can. This shit. I did it. Oh my god. That was annoying. Okay, need to solve. December 21st, 2022. All right, so what's going on here? We have our monkeys, they do math. We just need to evaluate the math. And so this is pretty simple. We parse the monkeys. It's kind of annoying, but we do it. And then we have a way to evaluate them with a universe of values, which is basically, we just look up their two operands, and if they're both some value, we apply the operation. Great. So for the first part, we have our monkeys. We create a hash table of names to monkeys. We get all our monkey values. While we haven't evaluated everything, we iterate over all of the monkeys. If we haven't computed a value for the monkey, then we try to evaluate it. If we still can't evaluate it, we don't do anything. If we can evaluate it, we add it to the computed values, and eventually this will converge because we'll evaluate everything. So then for part two, we don't evaluate human. Human is just a variable, and we need to provide a value to human so that we produce the correct output at the end. So that in the root, this is actually an equals sign. So we set the human to be a human, and then we also set the root to be, we can transform it to an equal, and then we do the same thing. We evaluate as much as we can, and this is where it just shot me in the foot, because at first I had this last size. We want to do this until the size of the monkey values stops changing. And at first I was setting monkey tables. I was updating last size down here, which is incorrect because obviously we then compare it to exactly the value we just set it to. So then I was like, oh, it needs to go up here, but then I put it inside the loop instead of outside the loop. And so for a long time, it wasn't running as long as it should. I can print out these evaluations. And then I try to solve it. And so to solve a human, we basically say the root should be 0. This actually doesn't really matter what this should be. But then we, if it's a human, then it should just, solving is returning what the value of human should be. And what if we're trying to get this value. So if we're trying to get human to be dest value, then we return dest value. And the idea is that in the input, there are no, every value is only used once, so there are no every value is used once, so it's not possible that, like, as if you try to evaluate something, if you try to evaluate something, I finished a couple minutes ago. If you try to evaluate something, one of the sides will get evaluated and only one side won't be able to be evaluated. So because we know what the operations are, we can solve for the other side. So if it's a human, we return that. If it's a num, we shouldn't ever call that. Otherwise, we get the two operands and the operation. Look up their values. And then, what just happened? Need to solve. So then, I don't think I need opcar either. So if we try to evaluate it, if both sides are none, then we're stuck. We can't solve both sides. If both sides are already evaluated, that's also wrong because we already have solved both sides. If we've solved one side and the operation is equal, then we want the other side to be, the unsolved side to be the, what we, to be equal to the other side. And then, like, so if it's supposed to be, the two things are supposed to add up to the dest value, then we solve the unsolved side for the destination value minus the solved side. It's a little tricky with minus because you kind of need to, like, flip it around. It's not symmetric depending on which side is unsolved. And then eventually you get down to the human, at which point you can solve the human. Yeah.